Today I'm going to be unboxing a Rusty Dots Furby I got from Mexico. Now, this particular Furby I got from a seller called, well, not a seller, he's a YouTuber. His YouTube name is kealkowa, and he had a Rusty Dots Furby that was actually circuit bent. And I'll post a link to his video below, but anyway, I wanted a Rusty Dots, so I contacted him and bought his. It does still have the circuit bending thing attached to it, but I probably won't use it. Missing an eyelash, he said he couldn't find it, but I have extra ones, so I can probably, so I'll just attach one. What is that? Is that a stain? I don't know. I'll take care of it. Let's just see. Does this have batteries in it or anything? There's no battery screw there either. But let me. I don't know if this thing has batteries in it or not. I don't necessarily. I don't really want to use this thing. So I'm just gonna. I don't think. So I'm gonna see if it has any. Let's see. How do you open this thing? Doesn't look like it has any actual power going to this thing. I guess it just gets bad power from the Furby's compartment. Okay, well that's off now. I didn't realize that was so loosely attached. This looks like one of those. This looks like a modified. This looks like it was originally some kind of just light up smiley face button. Oh, you can't see it, can you? Yeah, I'm sorry. Bad angle.
Yeah, that was the inside of that thing.
Okay, anyway. Sorry, I'm trying to reach. I'm to reach over the camera. Well, camera. I call it. It's a phone, but you know what I mean. Let's just. Okay, so that's gonna just be loose now, apparently. We'll deal with it later. This is just a Furby as is, and I probably will detach this from it, but we'll see. Maybe it'll start this way. Maybe it's chained. Well, this fur needs some cleaning anyway, I think. Not too bad. But. Doesn't seem to be turning on as is. So let me. I'll come back. Okay, I got it working. I had to clean the battery compartment with white vinegar.
Didn't really look that corroded, but it's speaker doesn't seem to work though. Hold on. Wake up. Oh come on, no, it's just working. Don't tell me touch this is not working either. Okay. Just reset it again. Yeah, I'm gonna use this one. Yeah. He's mute. But I can fix that too. Keeps going to sleep though. Come on, stop it. This might be. This thing might be affecting the touch, so I don't know. Okay, I think he's awake. Let's test the other senses. Tickles. Tickles since it doesn't seem to want to work either. I might have to replace a bunch of senses and let's see how the back. Okay, pet seems to work. Let's try feeding him. I don't think that's him reacting to the tickle sensor. I think that's him reacting to the sound of being pressed against. Yeah, because let's see. Because yeah, that's not doing anything. So that whole front thing must be messed up. Let's see. Does this do anything? That turns him off, apparently. Oh, I see. He's got a switch. This doesn't seem to. Oh, is it working now? Oh, it is working. So pressing this button made the tickle sensor work? Doesn't seem to. Of course I can't. Of course, it's got no sound coming out, so I can't tell if that's really doing anything or not. Well, it was working. Hold on. Okay, there it goes. I think. Okay, it seems like that's working now. See, let's try to see if we can get the tilt sensor working or not. It's hard to tell when you can't hear him hear what he's saying. Somebody's been pressing that makes the tickle button not gonna work. I don't know. I'm gonna have to get a new speaker in him so I can really tell what's working and what isn't. So I'm gonna open him up and work on that. Okay. Batteries are out again. I'm gonna open him. Careful not to cut those wires. They go in the, that's the end of him anyway. I'm not sure if I'll detach that or not, it depends. But, man, this is getting hard. Am I doing this the wrong direction or something? I've cut these before, they're usually not this hard to cut. Unless someone put a... Well, you say he didn't modify this himself. He had it done by some professional guy. Okay, there we go. Let me take that out because it's easier to slide this off. And I won't remove the ears unless I have to. Sometimes I can get into these without doing that, but it's probably easier if I do. Let's see, is he... Okay, his Facebook's not attached. Oh, wait, that ear... Oh. Huh. Oh, the ears aren't even sewn to the... Oh, wait, that's broken. I didn't know. There's nothing in there. In a way, that's good that the ears are sewn down to the fur. Which means I don't have to. They seem like they were moving fine. I will replace that one, though. I'm still out of this frame, don't I? Yeah. This one. It's not in there, is it? No, is it? Well, is it? It's kind of hard to... Oh, yeah, there it is. But that'd be too hard to glue. Is it sewn to it? I can't tell. Oh, the other end actually does seem like it's attached to it, but yeah, but there's no real way I can glue that, so I'm just gonna have to put a new one in there, probably. The fur didn't look too bad, but I'll clean it as well. Let's see. Do I have... Wow, this... Okay, no screws on that one side. Let me... Oh, God, no, this side. Feel free to skip ahead if you don't want to see me opening this whole thing. I might actually speed this up and process this thing. Maybe not. I mean, again, you can always skip ahead if you don't want to see me opening it. I don't have any. I might need a different screwdriver for some of these screws. I'm not sure. That one's... Let me just try. I've got a bunch of screwdrivers here, so I don't have what I need. Make sure I'm holding at least in the frame. I'm sure anyone, any longtime Furby fans have seen a Furby open before or done it yourself, so I'm just recording this for posterity. So you can see my process working on this thing. And again, I'm not sure, let's see. That one looks tiny, can I? This one does have a small option on it. That's good when you have one that has multiple heads on it. Screwdriver with multiple heads, not a Furby. A Furby with multiple heads, that'd be like a Chimera Furby, wouldn't it? Chimera, is that what they call them? The multi-headed snake dragon thing. That is what it's called, right? I'm not misremembering that, am I? Has anyone made a Furby Chimera? I don't have much room on this phone. I almost should have used a camera for this. So I'm not going to record everything, but here it is with the fur off. And it looks like... Let's see, that's going there. Seems like I could just... Detach those pretty easily. And this one is going... I think it's going into the speaker, which... I wonder if the speaker will actually work if I detach that. I don't know, I'm not gonna... never seen one with a purple plastic there. I don't have much room in here, so I'm gonna have to skip stuff, but I'll record once I get to... another thing, and of course I'll, after I fix everything, I'll make a new video too. That'll be, that might be separate from this one though. I don't know, we'll see. Yeah, the speaker is definitely damaged. This thing is coming loose on it, so I'll just have to replace that entirely. The speaker's been replaced. I decided to just leave this attached to it because, well, I don't know. I just didn't really want to take. I might take it out at some point, but it's kind of. I kind of want to leave it on there. You know, it's interesting. I don't have to use it. You know, it's just there if I want to. Last thing, I'm gonna glue this spare eyelash I have on there. He has to go back to sleep again. He has one of those, his tilt sensor isn't great. It'll work, but it takes a minute. And it's one of those ones you can't take apart to clean, so unfortunately. So you just kinda have to deal with it. Wait a minute. Might see better reset, but think it'll rub eventually if I leave it. Let it set up, I don't know. Maybe not. Let's just reset it. Just kind of whatever. There we go. Yeah, it's got the default name. It doesn't change it. I just put wrapped a bunch of scotch tape around that ear rather than actually placing it. It had a different shape to it. Let's see. Can it dance? If I hold it upside down, does it detect that? Not really. Maybe eventually it will, I don't know. Shame, there's nothing I can do about that. I was gonna clean it. It's tilt sensitive, but like I said, it's got one of those ones that... It's made differently, some of them are made differently, and I couldn't figure any way to pry it open. Oh, that. Oh, I thought it was going well, but he's just hearing something. I'll leave it on its side a moment, see if it eventually detects the thing. No. When I had the fur off, it was doing a little bit, but maybe it's too tight now. Well, if it doesn't, then it doesn't. Yeah, it really doesn't want to take any kind of movement. That's unfortunate. There's nothing I can do about it. I might detach this eventually, I don't know. It seems like, you know, I thought about attaching it to that one, but I'm not sure if I really want to do that. I could literally just cut it here. It doesn't, I mean, all the original wires are inside them are where they would normally be. This is just an add-on. So if I really didn't want this attached, I could just cut it, but for the moment, I'm just going to leave it alone. So anyway, he's in the right shape. I'll probably make another video of this when it's brighter, and or maybe I'll add it onto this video. Who knows? If not, bye for now. I desoldered and resoldered the tilt sensor, and it works a bit better now, but only if you hold it upside down. Doesn't seem to be able to do the wee thing, but it does recognize when you turn it all the way upside down.
So that's something at least. I don't know why it doesn't work with this. It's really weird. Yeah, that's strange. Yeah, it just doesn't know it's been picked up. I don't know. I don't understand it.